Okay, so in our previous types, we have seen complementary function when the roots are real and distinct. So in the next type, we are going to see complementary function when the roots are real. Roots are real and they are repeated. Roots are real and repeated. I'll give an example. Let us say if I write d square plus say 3d and say minus 4 equal to 0. Now obviously when I write d square plus 3d minus 4 equal to 0, you can very easily identify that's a quadratic equation and it will have two roots. Again, minus 4, I can write 4 into 1. 4 1 that is 4 and 4 minus 1 will give me 3 also. That means the factors of this equation is d plus 4 and d minus 1 equal to 0. These are the factors of the given equation. So obviously, no value is repeated here. The roots are real, but it is not repeated. See what can be done. If I write whole cube here, that means d square plus 3d minus 4, this particular expression is repeating 3 number of times. That means the highest power of d, it is d square here, and I'm taking cube of it. So the highest power of d becomes d raised to 6. That means you should definitely get 6 roots of d, 6 values of d. Now these values need not be different, they might be repeated also, as in this particular case. So I have taken d square plus 3d minus 4 and it is taken with the whole cube. So this particular equation is giving me the factors d plus 4 and d minus 1, and since the entire bracket is with power 3, this will also come with power 3. That means the value of d, it is from here, it is 1, and this 1 will repeat 3 number of times, and the other value of d is minus 4, it is going to repeat again 3 number of times. So 1 and minus 4, these are the real values, the real roots, and they are repeating. So 1 is repeating 3 number of times, minus 4 is also repeating 3 number of times. If you observe how many roots have come, we have got 6 roots. Why 6 roots have come? Because d had power 6. The first term is d square and it is taken power 3, so it will become d raised to 6. That means there should be 6 values of d. The values need not always be different. Sometimes they may repeat also. So this was roots are real and repeated. Now let us see how to write the complementary function. Observe carefully. So the complementary function is written as 1 is the first root repeating 3 number of times. I write yc is equal to the complementary function equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square. Observe carefully how the expression is written over here. There were 3 roots which are repeated. So I'm writing c1, then c2x, and then c3x square. This 1 is going to go in the power of the exponential term. That means I write a raised to x. But since it is repeating 3 number of times, I should write c1 plus c2x plus c3x square. The next root that is repeating is minus 4. So this minus 4 is going to go in the power of the exponential term. So I'm going to get e raised to minus 4x. But since minus 4 is repeating 3 number of times, and already I have gone up to c3, I will continue from c4. The basic rule of differential equations. Whatever the power of d, whatever the power of d, that many constants has to come in your complementary function. So since the power of d was 6, you have to get 6 constants into your complementary function. 3 of them are already done, 3 more are left, and 3 are going to come because minus 4 is repeating 3 number of times. So I write c4 plus c5x plus c6 x square, and since minus 4 is root, I write e raised to minus 4x. So that is how we write the complementary function when the roots are repeating. So in general, let us say m1 is the first root which is repeating, let us say, 2 number of times. M1 was my first root, it is repeating 2 number of times. I'm going to generalize this concept. Let us say m2 is the next root, the second root. It is repeating 3 number of times. So I took m2, it is repeating 3 number of times. Let us take m3. The next rule, it is repeating say 4 number of times. M3 is repeating 4 number of times. Let's take the next rule as M4. It is only coming once. So M1 is a root which is coming 2 times. M2 is a root which is coming 3 times. M3 is a root which is coming 4 times. M4 is a root coming only once. If you count the total number of roots, so there is 2, there is 3, that's become 5, then there is 4, it becomes 9 and 1. So there are 10 roots that I've got. Some of the roots are repeating. All of the roots are real. So roots are real and they are repeating also. So how do I begin? So M1 is the root. Root will go into the power of the exponential term. That means I get e raised to M1x. M1 is repeating 2 number of times. I write C1 plus C2x. Next root is M2. So I'm going to write e raised to M2x. The root will go into the power of the exponential term. M2 is repeating 3 number of times. Hence, I will write C3 because already C2 is over. So I have already continued my constants up to C2. The next constant that I will be getting is C3. So I write C3 plus C4x plus C5 x square because it was repeating 3 number of times. So C3, C4, C5, 3 constants will come. The next term is M3. This root is M3. This root will again go to the power of the exponential. I have e raised to M3x. E raised to M3x. So this M3 is repeating 4 times. I have already written constants up to C5. I will begin from C6. So I write C6. Then C7 into x. Then C8 into x square and C9 into x cube. Power of x will keep on ascending, it will keep on increasing. As and when the constants will keep on coming, the roots will keep on coming. As many roots, as many constants. So that was my third root M3. The last root is M4 and is only coming once. I simply write C10 e raised to M4x. So this is how you should be writing the complementary function if the roots are real and repeated. Whatever the number of roots are given to us, they have to be simply real. And if any of the roots are getting repeated, observe carefully how it was written. If M1 was repeating 2 number of times, I will write C1 plus C2x. If it is going to repeat for 3 number of times, I will write C1 plus C2x plus C3x square. 4 number of times, I will continue to x cube and so on. So that was the second type of the complementary function. I hope you have really understood well. We will be looking at the third type in the next video.